pronatal function is available for the Hamilton C1, Hamilton T1, and the Hamilton MR1. It works the same way for all three ventilators and helps you provide optimal care for even the tiniest, most fragile of patients. We'll now use the example of the Hamilton C1 to show you how to set up the ventilator, how to initiate neonatal ventilation, and how to adjust the neonatal ventilation modes. It works the same way on the Hamilton T1 and Hamilton MR1. Make sure you are using a dedicated neonatal expiratory valve, which has the same membrane as the other valves but a smaller internal diameter. Insert the neonatal expiratory valve. Connect the inspiratory and expiratory limb of the neonatal breathing circuit to the device. Connect the tubes of the neonatal flow sensor to the device. And connect the flow sensor with the Y piece. Now take the neonatal test lung and connect it to the flow sensor. While in standby, select the neonatal option. Adjust the actual weight of the patient. And then select the ventilation mode. The modes overview is divided into volume adaptive, pressure controlled, and non-invasive modes, including high flow oxygen therapy. Select the desired mode and press confirm. The controls window opens automatically. The default settings for the control parameters and alarms are calculated based on the weight of the patient. Check them and adjust if necessary. Save your changes by pressing confirm. Now you can adjust the alarm settings. Open the alarms window and adjust the default settings as required. When you have finished, close this window. Now you need to carry out the pre-op check. Open the pre-op check window. Carry out the necessary tests by following the instructions on the screen. When all tests have been completed successfully, you can close this window. Now you are ready to start ventilation. Please note that while ventilation is running, you can switch to any other mode except to NCPAP or NCPAP PC or high flow oxygen therapy. To switch to the NCPAP modes, you need to go back into standby. Open the modes window again and select the desired NCPAP mode. Make the necessary changes to the system according to the instructions on the screen. Firstly, disconnect the flow sensor from the breathing circuit and the tubes from the ventilator. Then connect the pressure monitoring line to the ventilator. There are two ways of connecting the pressure line to the circuit. A, if using nasopharyngeal CPAP, you need to attach the pressure line to the Y piece. B, if using binasal CPAP, remove the Y piece, attach the T piece to the pressure port of the inspiratory limb, and plug the pressure line into the T piece. Now check the default settings for PEEP, CPAP, and oxygen, and adjust them if necessary. Save your adjustments with confirm. The pre-op check window opens automatically. For optimal tube resistance compensation, you need to calibrate the circuit. Simply follow the instructions on the screen. After calibration has been completed successfully, close the window and check your alarm settings. Adjust the flow and pressure settings if necessary. When you have finished, close the window. Now you can connect the circuit with the NCPAP generator and then start ventilation. The NCPAP screen shows you a pressure curve and four monitoring parameters: P-peak, PEEP, oxygen, and inspiratory flow. Note that there is no detection for apnea or disconnection in NCPAP mode. If the patient needs more ventilation support, you can change to NCPAP pressure control. Open the modes window, select NCPAP PC, and confirm the change. Adjust the default parameters if necessary, and confirm. The device automatically starts ventilation in NCPAP PC according to your settings.